Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making butterscotch pudding dessert. And the flavor butterscotch is coming from butterscotch pudding. So if you don't like butterscotch pudding, you could change that to chocolate pudding or vanilla pudding or lemon pudding. Any kind of pudding that you can find prepackaged that you can put together along with milk will work, and you can just change the variety anytime you want. But this is going to be butterscotch pudding dessert. We start with making a little crust. And in this skillet, I have melted 2 sticks of butter. So that's 1 whole cup of butter that we melt. To that, I'm adding 2 cups of all-purpose flour. And I thought I would just mix it right here in the skillet. I let it cool just slightly. I don't want to cool it until it would congeal, but this is not extremely hot. So I'll put in our 2 cups of flour and also 1 cup of chopped pecans. And that's all we need for the crust. So I'll stir this around and it will make a little dough, and that will be spread out in a baking pan or baking dish, and then we will put it in the oven. Here is the dough for our crust, and you can see it's nice and workable, so I'm going to put it in this 13 by 9 by 2 inch baking dish. It's just a Pyrex dish that can go to the oven, so if you have something similar, it can even be metal if you want, but you'll be baking this in the oven. Once you get all of the dough in, then use a spoon or your hands to press this out evenly into one layer. Here's our crust ready to go to a 375 degree oven. And we're going to bake this maybe 20 to 30 minutes. I'm just going to keep an eye on it and I will tell you how long my oven took. Our crust is done after 20 minutes. In a 375 degree oven. You can see what it looks like. It's going to be a little bit browned around the edges, and it should be nice and golden, and it should look like a big cookie. What we're going to do now is set it aside and let it cool. You don't want to put any of the further ingredients on top of a hot crust because they're going to be kind of creamy. You don't want them melting down. When your crust is almost cool, you can start mixing up one of your toppings. The topping that I'm going to mix up now has 8 ounces of cream cheese, or you may use Neufchâtel cheese. So it should be softened so that you can work with it. And you just put it in a large bowl because you're going to mix it with sugar. This is 1 cup of white granulated sugar. And I'm going to take my mixer and mix these two together before I go on. Here's our mixture of cream cheese and sugar, and it should be nice and smooth after you've mixed it with a mixer. Now to this, we're going to add whipped topping, and you can get a lot of different varieties of this with low fat, low sugar. This is just regular, but this is 8 ounces, and I'm going to empty it into my bowl, and what I want to do is fold it in, so we should have a nice fluffy result. Here's the layer that goes on top of our crust, and you can see it's nice and fluffy. I'm going to make the next layer that goes on our dessert, and that is butterscotch pudding. And I'm going to use the packaged variety. If you want to make homemade butterscotch pudding, that would work fine. If you want to change the flavor, that's fine too. When you use these packs, you normally add them to milk, and you either shake them or whip them until they are congealed a little bit. These are instant. So a small pack of instant, I need 3 of those in order to make this topping. Now I'm adding 4 1/2 cups of milk, which is not the same proportion that is given in the directions of your pudding box, but for this recipe you want it a little sturdier. So 4 1/2 cups of milk, and then just add in your 3 small packs of any brand you want of pudding. and any flavor you want. Then mix. You can use a mixer. I've chosen to use an immersion blender here. Our crust is cool, so we're ready to assemble our dessert. So we've got our nice crust here. If you want to speed up the cooling of that, after it cools a little bit, you can put it in the refrigerator. And then after that, you can put it in the freezer for a little while if you want to. I wouldn't try to freeze it solid, but just to cool it down, you might do that. Now we're going to put the first topping, and that is the cream cheese whipped topping layer. So you can just kind of spread it out a little bit as you get it out of the bowl, and that will make our spreading easier later on. After you have your cream cheese layer nice and smooth, like this, then you can put on your butterscotch pudding layer. And there's a lot of this, so if your container doesn't seem deep enough, then just don't put it all on. You don't have to have all of this to make a nice dessert. After you've leveled out your butterscotch pudding, then you can put a nice topping on. What I've chosen is just to put a whipped topping, and this is, I think, a reduced sugar, it's light. Don't know if it's the fat or the sugar that's reduced, but it's light, so it didn't really match the other kind, but it didn't have to. You're just going to put that over the top for looks and for taste. The whipped topping is your last layer, except I'm going to put some nuts on top of this. So you might want to maybe make some peaks or shapes in it to indicate this is the end. But our next thing to do is just take as many chopped pecans as you like and sprinkle them over the top. I'm not going to put a whole lot because we have those pecans in the crust. So there's our butterscotch pudding dessert, and I think you'll like it. I'll take a bite for you in just a minute. What you'll usually do with your finished butterscotch pudding dessert is put some plastic wrap over the top and put it in your refrigerator until it's time to serve. I think this is cool enough that I can slice a piece out and let you see what it looks like and take a bite and give you my impression of the taste. It's kind of hard to get pieces of this sort out, particularly if they haven't had a chance to sit. So this may be just a spoonable dessert at this point, which is good still, but hopefully I can show you something a little more than that. Don't know. We'll start right here and go down, try to get that crust and bring it up, and then go to a plate with it. Now normally, the topping will not go down and drape over the side like that. You'll be able to see the individual layers actually on that end. You can't see them either, but I'm going to kind of brush this up a little bit so that you can see that there are layers in there. And then I'm going to take a bite for you. So I have my coffee ready, and I'm just going here to get some of each layer and a little bit of that crust on the bottom. That should be good. Mm-hmm. Tastes wonderful. I love that butterscotch flavor. If you don't like butterscotch, just change that part out. Make it any flavor you like. This makes enough for a crowd. So you probably will enjoy making it for people that might be coming over, because you just have to make one dessert. And also, it keeps really well. You can make it ahead of time. And it's the kind of thing that most people do like, although you can change it in ways to reduce the fat and reduce the sugar if you should choose to do so. One other plus it has, it's very easy to put together. The only baking you do is the crust, and the rest you just kind of spread or mix or do something like that. So I think you'll really like it. I hope you get to try it.